Kia ora, guys. Welcome to another episode of F1 2018.
All right.
So, on the last episode, we were in Monaco, which was a very difficult track. Just clipping that wall coming out of the tunnel heaps of times, and also clipping the wall when coming onto the start-finish straight. Hey, g'day, Skull Rush. So today we're making our way to Canada now. So let's just jump into it. Where am I sitting? I am currently sitting 7th among the list, and my teammate is sitting 19th. All right. I've got some work to do. I've nearly caught up with the F1 2019 season, so once I do that, I can just follow the days when they've got a race, so that'll give me an extra day. We can probably do some more GT Sport or find another game to fill in the spot. That's a lot of diff points.
That's a great result. You did really well.
All right.
I don't think we can have any complaints with that performance.
All right. Solid results. We've met expectations. All right.
You have to do a better job completing the goals the team set out for you. Their ability to develop will suffer if you miss them. And it'll count against you at the contract reviews.
Okay. So either way, we've got to improve.
If it were me, this is probably what I'd invest in.
Alright, let's invest in that just to get him to finally get off our case and... Alright, what about this? Insufficient points. Alright. That's fine. The car, now. Alright, that's getting pretty much to the end of its life. And stretching these parts pretty hard. Okay, the event gearbox is done, so let's get a new one. Alright, I think we're good. As the current gearbox has fulfilled its requirements, the new gearbox will now be fitted without triggering a pin. Do you want... Yes, I want the new gearbox to be fitted. More messages. The details. Alright, and we gotta be sunny. Sweet. It'll be a fairly easy race. I hope, anyway. Okay, don't have a lot of knowledge about Canada.
Here we are, live in Montreal at the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve, where the teams are making final preparations before today's practice session gets underway.
Hey
In 1999, the outside track wall, situated on the last corner of the lap, ended the race of three Formula One world champions, Damon Hill, Michael Schumacher, and Jacques Villeneuve. Since then, the wall has come to be known to fans around the world as the infamous Wall of Champions.
Turns 13 and 14 are definitely the most demanding corners on the track. A quick chicane section, entering at over 180 miles per hour, drivers use plenty of curb and get very close to the wall. But hitting those curbs at the wrong angle can easily put the car offline. You'll see a lot of drivers bail out of committing into turn 13 using the escape road to avoid contact with the wall.
All right, session info. All right. Car setup. Yeah, give me balanced for this first one. Okay, hyper softs, super softs, and ultra softs. Okay. Alright, let's get accustomed to this track. Drive out.
Let's get a few laps under our belt.
Okay. Button check. Make sure the buttons are good. Alright. There we go. Okay, let me tune up the force feedback a bit. Where is it? There it is. I'll go back. Custom, this is what I want. There we go. Let's bump that up to 40. Okay, that feels a little bit better. Missed that gate. Oh, I missed that gate too. Okay.
let's try for purple. You'll get a bonus for consistency if you can chain good corners together. This circuit, this is a really strong foundation to build from over the weekend.
Okay, strong start. Oops. Alright, let's just bring it in. Jump to the next one. Pit lane is just ahead. Straight ahead. This is it.
There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
Okay, it's not 100%, but I'll take it so that we can just jump to the next test. Team objectives. Okay, average tire wear. All right, we'll do flying lap. That's a bit too much. Oh, I'm slow though. Thank you.
was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
Okay, tests are going good. Alright, bringing it in. Okay, tests are going real good. All right, fuel management now. Ooh! Not paying attention. Wing is damaged. going for repairs. Gotta botch that. Alright, while that's going on,
car repairs have set us back a little.
Let's get a little bit of downforce. Okay, cool. Car is repaired. Got increased downforce. Session info. Alright, bring us out there for fuel management again.
Okay, we'll alter the setup of the car.
Out there, but there's still more to find. Keep at it.
Oh shit, that was bad.
Okay, you weren't quite good enough that lap. Try again.
I we go, that's better.
That lap time moves us into P13, 13th place.
Alright. How much qualifying time do we have, or practice time do we have left? Alright, only 3 minutes. Don't have enough time. Alright, let me get us some setup time.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1 minute 15.9. Okay,
let's move that up. Yeah, I think that's what I want. Move that down. All right. All right, let's accelerate time.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are Hamilton, Ricciardo, and Max Verstappen. Practice times are on the board then, but no points are on offer just yet. We'll be back with more F1 action soon.
Okay, that was a good practice session. Thank you. Let's just jump into it.
Take a set of intermediates in these unpredictable conditions.
Okay, ERS management. Okay. This shouldn't interfere too much.
Checks complete. We're ready.
Unpredictable of when I gain control. Ooh, come on, car. Purple Rain, oh, that's a clever bloody title for a trophy.
There's 3 laps of fuel remaining.
Alright, let's bring it in. With these wet conditions, I saved myself a set of good tyres.
Light rain will stay with us for at least 20 minutes, maybe more. Light rain is here to stay.
How we doing?
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:24.4.
These two qualifying pace. I think I'm going to have to wait until the dry day to do that one.
Are your best bet in the current conditions.
Alright, rain is here to stay, yep. Hang on. However, the team can use the data. Okay. All right. Let's do it. Not a good start. L2. We'll do it here. There we go, further back. From there. Going real easy on the throttle. Mm-hmm.
well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can talk you through the numbers.
They gave me P3. Ooh.
I'd take a set of intermediates in these unpredictable conditions.
Okay. Beat the average speed trap. Where would the speed trap be? I'm guessing it would be on the long straight. Can't really achieve top speed. All right. How's my car bits doing?
Times are dropping. Looks like track conditions are starting to improve.
Okay, I don't know what I just did. Alright, we're wasting time. Let's get this one out of the way. Oh, because of AR34, yes. I think it's because I'm either early or I'm playing something that isn't Gran Turismo. Ah, damn it! There wasn't enough time to complete this one. Okay. No. Let's save our tires.
Classification at the end of the session then, here are your top three: Ricardo, Verstappen and a Toro Rosso. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for...
Damn it, I had to take that last practice session. Let's view the R&D tree.
I recommend we could go for something like this.
Alright, yeah, give me that. Alright, final practice session. Alright, how's the weather? Looking all good? Alright, drive out.
Okay, the track is green right now, so take a few laps to get the tyres up to temperature. Try and feel your way around.
Get these tires warmed up.
Super job so far, we're getting great data. Stay focused. super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused. Keep it up. Out of fuel. You need to pit within the next two laps.
Ooh. Hey, Daniel, probably not until next year. Yeah, I just purchased a F1 2018 pretty much at the start of this year. So, just play the crap out of this game for a bit.
Box this lap, please. Box this lap.
Oh, out of gas. Yeah, I'll probably get F1 2019 maybe next year. Good practice session. Alright. 20 or 25. Alright, I want to get that last one. What do I want to do it in?
Our best lap so far is a 1 minute 14.7.
Yeah, I think I'll do it in this one. Car setup. Alright, let's try for increased speed.
Alright. Okay, let's update the setup.
Right, hopefully the car will be fine.
Fantastic. You obviously have a really good understanding of this circuit.
Oh, I missed it.
This circuit. This is a really strong foundation to build from over the weekend. Thank you. very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that.
Okay, I think I've got enough practice now. Don't know about wasting a pair of hypersauce for this. Damn, this car sounds terrible. It's something rattling, and I don't like it.
Less than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty.
Did I get that last one? Yes, I did. Sweet. Alright.
Our best lap so far is a 1:13.6.
Okay, that's good enough for me. I've completed all the challenges. Where do I currently sit? I sit second.
An interesting practice session there then. Let's remind ourselves of the top three, who are Hamilton, Toro Rosso, and Sebastian Vettel. Thank you for joining us for free practice today. We'll be back with more Formula One action very shortly.
Oh, pardon me. Got a fair amount of dev points. All right, let's go in. Do your best out there, secure a good spot on the grid. Sweet, I'll be getting 500 resource points. Qualifying, it's just cloudy, and then racing, we got sunny, then cloudy weather. When it comes to Canada, the main advice I can give you is remember that you can probably carry more speed into some of these corners than you expect. But you can't be too greedy, that's what I'm all about. Some of the curves here can be ruthless. Alright. Okay, can't afford anything there, that's fine. What about up here? No, you can't afford anything, alright. Alright, qualifying time.
Welcome again then, and we hope you're ready for another fantastic session as the teams prepare to unleash their cars for qualifying at the Canadian Grand Prix. When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximizing top speed. So you simply remove as much downforce as possible, hang on in the corners and max out down the straights?
The teams will have arrived with all manner of parts designed to capitalise on the long straights. The cars will be that much harder to drive in the corners, but everyone will be in the same boat.
All right, session info. 29, 29, 29. All right, custom setup. All right, let's see what that does for us. Drive out.
All set. Everyone clear. Car to track.
Alright, you didn't see that. You didn't see that either, shit.
Are you alright? Engine off, engine off.
I didn't know the game would let me get control that fast. Better. Go. Alright, let's pick that up. P1. screwed up Hamilton's lap there. P3 at the moment. Oh, going down to P4. Oh, and here comes Hartley. Alright. Still got some quality time.
Our best lap so far is a 1 minute 12.6.
How are we doing? I'm fifth. Grid drop penalty? No, I don't want that. I wonder if I'm allowed to do this. Just pretty much completely rebuild the engine. I doubt it. Oh, I'll give it a go, see what happens.
We've dropped into P6.
And that doesn't mean I can. Yeah, screw it. Let's just skip the repair time. I think I blew it. I probably could have qualified a hell of a lot better.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Vettel, Bottas, and Daniel Ricciardo. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
All right, yep, that's fine. How we doing?
What do you think of this one?
All right. Alright, yeah, just go with what these guys suggest. Alright, I want that one. Alright, let's race.
We're back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to a variant of this track back in 1978. It was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour the circuit would be renamed. We'll be seeing top speeds of around 210 miles an hour here at the circuit Gilles Villeneuve, with around two-thirds of the lap taken at full throttle. High-speed chicanes spell potential danger, especially at the infamous Wall of Champions. And watch out for overtaking into the hairpin and the final chicane. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Red Bull. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do, and that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Hamilton, Kimi Raikkonen, and Verstappen, a Toro Rosso, Hülkenberg, Perez, and Kevin Magnussen, Sainz, Grosjean, Fernando Alonso, and Hartley, Stroll, Ericsson, Stoffel Van Dorn, and Sergei Sorokin. Ocon and Charles Leclerc rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Right, let's be patient going into turn one. We want to be in a good position for the rest of the race. Good luck.
All right, yep, that should be fine. Let's select that strategy. All right, let's begin. Oh, who's that beside me? Someone wants in.
That's a decent start. Good job. Thank you.
Let's back that up. I know I'm cheating a bit. Hopefully that's not too much damage.
Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
Ah, damn it, I got distracted. Green guy yapping away there. Ooh, I nearly got him. Squeezed by vessel. Yes, got him.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the ultrasofts. We're leading our teammate by 3.6 seconds. Faster engine modes are available. You have P3, P3, Ricardo ahead. Gap to car in front is 1.2 seconds. They're on old hypersofts. Vettel is behind you. Less than a second separate you. They're on old hypersofts. Our gap to first place is 1.7 seconds.
You got a yellow knot. Why?
Opens next lap. 14 laps to go. Push now. We're boxing this lap.
Okay, time to push.
Okay. Box this lap, please.
Save, I guess. Alright, to ultra softs now.
Go.
I think these will take us all the way to the end.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Yeah, it's a good bit of fun, this game. Hey, Chris, it's very difficult to handle these cars in the rain. I've done two wet weather races, and they were bloody difficult to try and control the car. Come on, Ericsson, you're slowing me down. There we go, got him. Alonso's next. Never caught up to Bottas. Think I'll have him here.
Okay, good work. Great pass.
Ooh, went wide.
You're leading the pack. P1, Bottas behind. The gap is less than a second. They're on fresh ultra-softs. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. 9 laps to go. Some information on Ocon. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Position, front of the pack. Bottas is behind you. They're on fresh ultra softs. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Behind. The gap to the car behind is 1.4 seconds. They're on fresh ultra
softs. 1.4 seconds.
Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 7 laps to go.
Okay, let's get some more distance. Yeah, I think we'll be good from here.
Behind is 28.4 seconds. Is behind you. Our gap behind is 1.8 seconds. They're on fresh ultra softs. Their tyres are 5 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:15.5.
Thank you.
behind is 2.4 seconds.
A little bit too much.
Repeat that, there's interference. Okay, our main competitors in this race are Ricardo and Hartley.
I didn't want to know that.
It should be a few laps at least before you start feeling too many tyre issues. They seem in good condition for the time being. Leading our teammate by 38.9 seconds. There's three laps of fuel remaining.
Okay, I can put on the rich rims all the way to the end. Tire status.
Quick word on the tires, they look okay for now, but we can see the wear. If you can't feel it already, then you'll certainly start too soon. Just be careful.
Full race update.
You are in first position, front of the pack, Bottas behind. The gap behind us is 4.7 seconds. They're on old ultra softs. This is your final lap of the race.
Don't do that. Freaking hell, I'm so close to the end. I think the tires are starting to go now. Tire status.
This is your final lap. Final lap. lap of the race, the gap to the car behind is 6.5 seconds.
There we go.
Absolutely fantastic. It's a brilliant result. Well done.
A great win then for the Toro Rosso team today. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
I think we'll chalk this one up to a deft touch on the brake pedal. That's allowed them to challenge down the inside into the braking zones, and ultimately, if you do that often enough, you end up winning the race. It was great to watch as well though, wasn't it? Forget strategy, forget tyre management. Who doesn't love a good old-fashioned scrap?
And it's time now for the podium celebrations, and how well-deserved is this one? This is a team all about giving talented young drivers an opportunity to race and to win. Toro Rosso are your winners here today. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Well, the lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
I think I'll have to give it to the Toro Rosso driver. They did a great job at getting the most out of their tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern day Formula One.
On to the constructors then. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. Meanwhile, Toro Rosso's strong...
Yeah, blah, 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 blah.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. How are you feeling after that win? You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you? You must be thrilled to be up on the podium. Things are looking up after last week, aren't they?
All right, let's go with the bottom one.
Great! Well, that's everything.
Nice, there's going to be some huge development points. Ooh, that's a big jump.
Fantastic podium, well done. Keep pushing like this for the rest of the season.
All right, we've got some messages.
We've received invitations to new historic events. You'll be able to choose whether or not to participate before the end of this weekend.
I don't really want to do the invitationals. All right, view the R&D tree, 510. All right. Don't have enough for that. All right. Okay. Oof, that was a good race. Got my second podium. Really good. All right. Well, that will conclude F1 2018 for another day. Like I said, I'm slowly catching up to the proper F1 season. And when that comes, I'll have a break in the week. So we might start playing one of the new games that I got in. Or just continue on with a longer session on GT Sport. Okay, guys, if you just give me 5 minutes, I'll take a break and reset the stream. And when we come back here, we'll just jump into GT Sport for about 5 or so minutes. Get ourselves all geared up for the Super Formula Invitational. Okay, guys. Just hang on a second. Give me time.